Hey, what's up everybody? Jumpin here. Today I'm going to be bringing you another Mass Effect 3 gameplay commentary. This is going to be Debuff City. Now you might be wondering, what the fuck is Debuff City? Well, what we're going to be doing in this video is that I'm going to be using the Grep Grenader build, which, you know, there was a little controversy over that I had, because the guy who made that was, like, I guess upset because I had a YouTube video of it, which, in the video, I talked about I didn't come up with the class, you know, like, it wasn't, like, my idea. I just had people comment to me saying that I should try it, and I didn't even look at the build. I just kind of, like, was like, okay, Falcon, Infiltrator, I think I understand this, and I made my build, and my build was even different from the guy who made the build originally, so... I mean, I don't know, but it wasn't really a big deal. I didn't really think it was. Didn't really bother me, but I guess it might have bothered him. So, you know, I'm sorry to that guy who made the class if you watch this video. But, you know, like, it just kind of happens, bro. So, that's all I got to say about that. But like I said, so this is going to be Debuff City. The idea of this is that we're going to actually be running around with all Saboteur-like characters. This is going to be Gold Cerberus on Glacier, and it's going to be absolutely epic. The way it's going to work is that, like I said, proximity mines are actually one of the best debuff-like powers in the whole game, because when you hit them with, when you hit enemies, especially big enemies, with proximity mine, they're going to take 20% more damage. So the characters that we're going to be using in this is going to be one Geth Infiltrator, which is me, playing as the Geth Grenader, one Solarian Infiltrator, also using proximity mines, and that's going to be Far Envy. And with this, those two alone, that's 40% extra damage. Then we're going to be playing with one Turian Sentinel with Warp. That's going to have Expose and Pierce. So that's going to be another 15% more damage from weapons and powers. And also, it's going to weaken armor by 25%. And that's going to be Richard. You guys know him as Dick, but I'm going to, you know, I've been calling him Richard now because the Dick jokes kind of got old. Didn't want to, like, you know, kill him out, you know, things like that. Funny why it lasted, but it just needed to stop. And then finally, it's going to be one human infiltrator. So there's three infiltrators on this team, and he's going to be using Cryoblast, and that's actually going to be Snide, or some kind of Snide. So, you know, the way this works is that with all the powers combined, the Cryoblast actually will do 25% more damage from all sources when you hit them with it. And it will also weaken armor by an additional 25%. So when you add up all the totals of the debuffs that we're going to be using, it's going to add up to be 80% more damage to the target, and it's going to add up to be 50% weaker armor. So that's absolutely madness. You know, like, how much damage you'll do, and you'll see it in this video, especially on the Atlases. That's the whole idea against Cerberus, is that it's mainly for Atlases. Like, this guy alone can pretty much deal with Cerberus, because of the Falcon stunning them and the proximity mine killing them, and then the Solarian's going to be energy draining them, and, you know, Snide's going to be using the Claymore on his human infiltrator, things like that. I mean, we are really overpowered right now, and this is, like, this game was extremely easy. So this is going to be the first Atlas, so we're going to go ahead and start hitting it with all our powers. At this point, I believe he's hit with everything. And then boom, as you can tell, once he got hit with something that was a little bit more stronger, either that was the Claymore or maybe the mine, it just did so much damage. I mean, he got dropped. You know, this would work against, this would work really well against Reapers and things like that. Here's going to be our next Atlas, so look at that. Like, just how fast, you know, he loses his armor because it's so weak, and then all the damage he's taking extra. You know, you're going to see that throughout this whole wave. It's just us, like, you know, move from Atlas to Atlas as a group. You know, like, teamwork in this game really is important. Like, when you can come up with things like this to do, I mean, look, once again, Atlas is almost dead instantly. When you can come up with something, an idea or something to try out in gold just for fun, like this, where we were like, you know, let's just go ahead and make a saboteur team, like a debuffing team. And, you know, and it just worked out fantastic. It just was a lot of fun to do. Now, obviously, if you don't have a lot of friends, you don't have a lot of people to play with, you know, this might not be as easy to do. Most of my videos are kind of like that, though. They're just kind of like to show you different things you can do, not necessarily things that you're going to be able to do. And I believe right here I might go down. Yeah, I'm going to go down. I was trying to get him up, but, you know, Geth Infiltrator is definitely a really weak character. So it's just kind of what happens. And, But, you know, I'm going to get picked up by Snides. That's what's up. And, like I said, anything on gold is a lot easier if you can have decent teamwork. Like, especially if you can roll as a group. Look at that. Oh, my God. That got freaking dropped. But, yeah, if you can roll as a group, you're going to just mow down enemies. Every time one of, you know, if one a person gets dropped out of a group, it's not a big deal at all because, you know, you're going to have all these other people with you to just instantly pick you up, you know, and that's amazing. Now, of course, if you play with randoms and stuff, you're not going to be able to do that. So, you know, like I said, like, this is a good thing about the clan, though, and I've been hoping that everyone in the clan have been, like, you know, branching out and playing with other people. You know, because if you are a part of the clan and you haven't been doing that, then you really don't need to be in the clan, because that's the idea of the clan, is that, you know, you're going to be playing with these people to either, you know, become friends with them, and things like that, so you just meet new people to play with, and that's the beautiful part about the clan, and that's what, you know, I want to see happen. I believe right here, I'm actually good. I thought maybe I was going to get dropped, but, like I said, but as you can tell, like, you know, we're going to be rolling together as a group, and, you know, just pretty much working together now. Like I said, now this character is so good at just murking the normal enemies, like, just because of the grenade launcher, you know. And I'll repeat myself like I did in the last video, this really needs to be the host only, like, doing this build, because Falcon just does not work right off host. Just try to keep that in mind. But, like, yeah, this you know, this guy's gonna just be able to run around and, you know, just murk all these normal enemies. Phantoms are not an issue. They get so stunned, and the proximity mine's just going to do so much damage to them. I mean, just by himself, just being able to hit him with proximity mine, and then, you know, you're going to deal 20% more damage to him. And this gun's already so powerful. Like, if you hit them with this, like, yeah, you'll wreck them. And with everyone else following you around, like, you know, having someone cryoblasting things. Now, if you're running around trying to use cryoblast, you're probably not going to get that many points. But, you know, that does not matter. You know, it's a team-based game, so it doesn't really matter. And you're really going to help your team out a lot. But I do not recommend, you might be wondering, can I use the Geth Corian Engineer? Well, here's the thing, guys, is that when it comes down to it, she's a great, like, assist character, like, support character, but she's not a very good, she's not a high damage character. So the Geth, I mean, the Human Infiltrator is definitely the way to go with that, and I recommend either a giant sniper or a giant shotgun for a build like that. And Claymore works really well, because you're really not gonna, the only power you're really using is gonna be cloak anyway, so it's really not a big deal. Okay, so this way we're gonna have Atlases and Phantoms, and it should be really easy, or it might just be Atlases, I'm not too sure. You know, this map is definitely a lot of fun to play gold on. It's so small, you can beat it very quickly. You know, and like I said, if you just roll around as a group, you know, as a group, you won't really have too many problems. Now, because it's such a small map, you can really be overwhelmed quickly if you're not careful. But, as long as, like I said, as long as you can work together with your teammates and just move around, like, this is a lot of fun. Like I said, so definitely you guys need to try out the debuff, you know, the debuff city, like, because, you know, I have never really read or heard anything about teams of saboteurs in this game. I mean, most RPGs always have some type of saboteuring class and, you know, our group of characters that can work well together. And this is definitely, in my opinion, the best group right here. The two infiltrators, you know, Slayer Infiltrator is definitely one of the best characters in the whole game, if not the best. And the Geth Infiltrator is definitely a really good character, like, overall, one of the most broken ones in the entire game when it comes down to damage. Honestly, when it comes down to just pure damage that you can do, you know, because of the Hunter mode, because of all the power damage bonuses, because of everything like that, and the weapon damage bonuses, like, from the cloak in the Hunter mode, like, definitely the Geth Infiltrator is probably the best character in the whole game for, well, in that sense, you know. So, with them two together is awesome. Turret Sentinel is amazing. And yeah, Human Infiltrator is really good. I mean, like, I believe Snipe was only, like, level 15 or 16 in this, but if he was 20, I mean, you can have maxed out sticky grenades, and that wrecks, too. Now, you might have been seeing Snipe in this video, like, goof around and shoot rockets at us and throw grenades at us and things like that, and you might be like, what the fuck is he doing? That's just Snipe, though, guys. Like, you know, I don't know what to say, but he's kind of like what you would call a troll in a lot of ways. But it's not a big deal. Nobody ever cares. It's just who he is, and it's sometimes you need people to do that. You know, like, it, don't take games like this seriously. You really shouldn't. So when you can have someone shooting rockets at your teammates that makes no, you know, makes no damn sense. You're like, what the fuck? Why is this guy shooting rockets at me? It just kind of, you know, it's just kind of a good thing. Like, it tones down the whole seriousness of it. You know, like, you don't need to take the game seriously, like, ever. That's pretty much what I'm saying here. And Snide's a prime example of that. He's a very casual player who just likes to have fun. And, you know, that's actually really funny and fun, like, for everyone when someone, when he goofs off like that. But, I mean, like, you know, if we're playing a goal game, and I remember before this game, he had no rockets. He literally had no rockets. Like, he was like, I have no rockets. I was like, well, you know, maybe you should buy some veteran packs and get some rockets. So he went ahead and he did that. And then when the game started, he started shooting rockets at us. And I was like, did you wonder why you have no rockets, bro? Like, what the fuck? Like, what are you doing? But, you know, like I said, so it's just something, you know, it's just something to keep in mind, guys. Don't take this game too seriously. It's not a game that needs to be taken seriously anyway. Alright, so as you can tell, this class, this Gefgrenator class, is just so broken. A lot of fun to play with. Like I said, remember, it is a host-only build, but, you know, if you're going to play on host anyway, then yeah, definitely try this out. It makes gold really easy. You know, works extremely well. You could probably solo with this. If you camped, you could totally solo with this, to be honest, on gold. It would be pretty easy. But you would have to camp, honestly. This guy's too weak to run around. But, you know, this wouldn't be a big deal. Right here's going to be another Atlas, so this should be fun. I believe we were trying to clear out the enemies before we went after it, but, you know, just look at that. The amount of damage, you could just tell from, like, I think every shot from, you know, that Carnifax, I think Envy's using the Carnifax, every shot from that and every shot from me is just doing so much damage. It's outrageous. Right here, we're just going to push up. Now, you know, when you're trying to roll as a group, you got to try to stay as a group. You know, you got, if you're ever slacking or on the other side, I believe someone's not with us right here. But if you're ever slacking, then you need to, like, readjust and find out where your people are, you know. Like, just because you don't, yeah, exactly. I think Envy's on the other side of the map, and we're like, bro, he was just like, oh, man, I'm pinned down by a phantom. And we're like, dude, what are you doing over there? Like, like, why did you go over there, man? Like, and he ended up running around. But like I said, you don't want to get separated from your group, especially if you're trying to do something like this where, you know, it's the idea of it is just that, it's not about who does, you know, the best or, you know, who does what. It's more about just working together and just really showing off how, like, teamwork can, you know, can, teamwork will always win in any game. You know what I mean? It really will. Like, it's better to have four people shooting one thing than it is to have one person shooting one thing. That's just how it works. In any multiplayer game, online, against people, or against even the AI, it just works amazingly, like, if you can have that happen. So, like I said, like, in this sense, like, because of what we're doing, we're saboteuring pretty much everything. We're debuffing all these big enemies together, and we're shooting everything together. They're dying so easily, and we're not having a problem. Every time we get dropped, most of the time we're going to be able to just get each other up pretty much instantly. If not, you know, we might, I think, in one wave we do have some problems. I'm not going to lie to you. Like, there is a wave where we don't really have a problem, but we kind of just, it just took us so long, and it's felt like we had problems, but alright, so, you know, when the phantoms get heavy, though, you know, just gotta be careful not to get assassinated. But besides that, it's really, like I said, if you were trying to run around with this class, it's not hard at all. Someone asked me, you know, how did this class work on gold, and I said it was really, really, worked really well, and as you can tell, it really does. You know, in this little spot right here, if you're rolling together, you really gotta watch out, or if you're ever finding yourself in that spot on gold, you know, especially against service, you gotta watch out for phantoms. Phantoms and other enemies, like right here, will constantly come up behind you, so, like I said, you really gotta, like, just watch your back and just play it smart, because, you know, this is a very small map, like I said, so the spawns on this map can be very random and kind of ridiculous at times. Like right there with the two atlases, I was like, yo guys, push into this room, you know, like, and that's something also you should always do. You know, you should always, if you see, like, a big threat like that, you know, use your voice, like, let your teammates know, like, hey, come on, let's get out of there, let's move. You know, like, I don't know, like, there should always be someone who has, you know, like, some type of leadership of your team. Like, it's just what it is. Like, you know, I don't know. Like, that's really, like, whatever. But I've always been, like, I've always been really big about trying to be a leader, in a sense, especially in video games, or just in anything. Like, I don't know. It's just, like, I've always been like that. That's just one thing I've, like, it's kind of weird in a way, because, I mean, I'm not going to lie to you. Like, when I play games and stuff, I always want to be party leader. I want the control of, like, just having party leader. And then when I'm playing the game, I like to, like, you know, bark out orders, or just to say, like, what we should do. Or, well, not demand what we should do, but more or less, like, suggest what we should do. And most of the time, you know, like, a lot of my decisions are pretty valid, you know, are pretty, like, decent. So I have a lot of people who kind of, like, follow me because of that. And, you know, I don't know. Like, so I guess in a lot of ways, I do believe I have a lot of good leadership like skills. But yeah, like I said, there should always be someone, you know, in the game who is trying to, like, you know, tell people, like, tell his other teammates what to do. Because, like, in situations, bad situations, if you can make the right call to get the hell out of there, you know, that's gonna really save yourself, like, a lot of trouble. You don't want to ever have, like, all your teammates go down and have everyone have to use metagel. That's just not a good thing. Like, that can really cost you later on and things like that. And look at that. That is absolutely crazy. Like, that was retarded. Like, how much damage we were able to... I think that was the Claymore. I don't know what that was. But as you could tell, it was absolutely amazing. And, yeah, this has just been a lot of fun. So I highly suggest you try this out. You know, like I said, the Gaff Infiltrator with this and the Solarian Infiltrator are really just two Solarian Infiltrators. Yeah, they work really well together with the Proximity Mine. I highly suggest Proximity Mine now because of the radius thing. You know, it's really good. Like, although, like, I don't think you need the radius. Like, you know, you really don't. Like, I just think the 3 meters of the default radius on Proximity Mine now, it's, like, it's pretty decent. You just shoot it anywhere around the enemy and it will instantly blow up. That's awesome, you know. So there's going to be another Atlas. We should wreck it really quickly. And I believe, now it's dead. One thing I wanted to bring out is that, you know, there was a lot of problems with the server this week. I'm sure a lot of people were, like, aware of this. And, you know, it was kind of, like, really bad. It was a little annoying. Mainly the problem I was having was that I was trying to get this gameplay. I was trying to get, like, the Turian Krogan gameplay for the week. And I just couldn't do it. I couldn't do it, guys. Like, it was just, like, you know, I wanted to get it on that day, and, you know, it delayed me quite a bit. And I have a lot of stuff I have to do as well this weekend, so hopefully I do have the Turian gameplay. I'm just gonna tell you that now, then I will be uploading that probably tomorrow, or whenever this video comes out, the next day. But the Krogan one, I'm not too sure if I'm even gonna be able to get that, but hopefully I will. So I'm not, you know, I'm not gonna give up on it, but I'm definitely going to try to get that gameplay and put it out there. So, but yeah, just keep that in mind. But also, Fun With Guns is going to definitely come out probably either Friday or Saturday, one of the two. I haven't really decided what day I want to bring that out. Okay, so this is going to be Wave 10. And this is actually going to be, you know, this is actually going to be like the devices. I hate these. It's one probably the worst objective you can ever get. But yeah, it's just, it sucks when this happens. And, I mean, I don't know. Anyway, another thing I did also want to bring out is that besides the fact that all these problems with the servers happened this week, they also did make another update to this game. I wanted to give you guys a little bit. I'm not going to tell you all. You can look it up on the forums. You can look it up online if you want to know all the updates. But there was some pretty big changes, honestly, like some pretty amazing ones as well. The first one being that, and this is absolutely ridiculous. There's so many phantoms around us. Wow. But yeah, as you can tell, this build really does well on just taking them out, you know. But yeah, you know, there was the biggest change I think that they made was to the human soldier. They made the frag grenade, like, absolutely amazing. If you guys don't know, with the frag grenade now you can have 4 frag grenades. That is crazy. They also up the power, so when you have maxed out power damage and maxed out frag grenade, it does, like, almost 1,400 damage. It does 1,387 damage now. And that's absolutely crazy. And then the final, like, thing, you can either have it do 75% more damage to shield or 75% more damage to armor. So they also upgraded that, and that is really crazy that they did that, because like the, as you remember with the Human Soldier on Gold video, like the Human Soldier with those frags were like, you know, it was really good. And you know, and also they did the same thing with the incendiary grenades too. So the Batarian Soldier is going to be better now too. Now he can carry 4 grenades. That is going to be really awesome, and something that he kind of needed. I mean, I don't know if he needed it, but it definitely is going to help. Alright, so right here, I'm just going to, like, be chilling at this little spot, trying to, like, pick them off. Like I said, any other things that you might, like, those are the biggest changes, honestly. It's just mainly the frag grenade is a huge change, but, you know, like I said, if you guys want to, and right here, this is terrible, but if you guys want to know more about that kind of stuff, just go ahead and look it up. You can find it probably on any forums. Right there, I just got the second kill streak. I only shot the rocket just because I knew I wanted to get that last kill streak if possible. And I believe we're about to get done with this ejector. Now, this is the wave I was talking about. Like, we definitely had a little bit of problems on this wave just because, you know, we were just getting surrounded by phantoms. I mean, that's what can happen. And right there, Snide, I believe, just got assassinated. And that, I believe he was also trying to pick up his teammate. Now, like I told you guys before, you know, it's always risky. Like, I think he did a mistake. Like, he did exactly what I told you guys not to do. If your teammate is ever down and there's a phantom by him, or if he was taken down by a phantom, because you should pay attention to the kill feed just to see, like, if they, you know, if you're teammate is brought down by a phantom, you know, or a turret or something like that, and you're like, oh, okay, now I know there's a phantom or turret by him, you know, just a good thing to do. But if you ever see some stuff like that, then, you know, you should try really hard too to, you know, not get assassinated, because if you try to just pick them up, there's a good chance that the enemy is going to be able to potentially assassinate you or grab you. And you just don't want that to happen. Right there, Snide shot another rocket at me. I mean, that's funny. Alright, now one thing about this map, guys, is very important for gold, is that I highly suggest holding down this middle room for the final extraction wave. Like, the idea is that you're going to bring all the enemies up to you, like, you know, like you're going to lure them up to the middle room, and by the time, you know, the last couple of 20 seconds or whatever, you're going to pretty much just be able to make a mad dash to the LZ. That's the idea here, at least. Like I said, so, you know, if you could just hold down this middle room, that's really good. The main thing you're going to need to do, though, is block the spawns. As you can tell, early on, I stood in that room to block that spawn, and I think someone stood in the back just to block that spawn. And at this point, you know, now you can kill them as they come up to you, or just let them come up to you. It just really doesn't matter. But, you know, if by killing the enemies in the final wave, they're just going to spawn again. And right there, as you could tell, you know, boom, 2 atlases just immediately spawn right, you know, right behind us. But because of our massive saboteur like abilities, like, we took them out so quick. I mean, it was absolutely ridiculous. Right here, Envy's gonna get a nice little 2-for-1 on the Guardians. So that was awesome. And like I said, so, you know, we're just gonna fight our way all the way up to the end. But yeah, this is, like I said, this Geth Grenader is definitely a lot of fun. So whoever made this class, I really appreciate it. I think his name was like Wild Snorlax or something like that. It's a really awesome class, and it's really, really fun to play with. So I highly suggest this to anyone. And like I said, if you guys want to have some fun, definitely try out this whole, you know, saboteur idea where, you know, you just run around and debuff the big enemies. Like I said, this would be also really good on Reapers, really on anything. This would work really well on pretty much anything you tried it on. I mean, when you can get 80% more damage and 50% weaker armor, that's really crazy. But yeah, as you can tell, you know, we're going to go ahead and get final extraction here. And, you know, the game's going to be pretty much over. One thing I want to say real quick, though, before this is over, you know, besides the fact that, you know, I got a pretty ridiculous score in this game because of how overpowered this guy is. But besides that, at the end of this video, it's going to be us sitting in the lobby for a little while. The reason why we were, you know, sitting in the lobby was because I forgot to hit uncaptioned, so that's going to be left in the video. But at this point, once the score is over with, you can pretty much just, the video's over. So just try to keep that in mind, guys. But besides that, like I said, you know, I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. It's a lot of fun. And, you know, please comment, please like, please subscribe, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So definitely have a nice day.